Hello and welcome again to the NFT Creative Awards videos. In this little space that we try to think and try to discuss and try to talk about what NFT represents right now. I want to talk today about some difficulties. No, I have to say that me as an art photographer, I have no big issues right now, because I started my career many years ago. I started selling to collectors some years ago. All my career, all my life, I was selling physical things, no, in exhibition basically, and to collectors, no. So I arrived one moment that everybody was this NFT thing 2 years ago, 1.5 years ago, was a kind of hype, no? Everybody was talking about, so I wanted to know exactly what is it, no? So I created my account, I minted my own, some of my own works, I sold some, and I realized, I wanted to really try to understand how it works, the full big picture, no, of NFTs, no? And it's quite interesting, but they have some very, very weak points for the moment. Decentralization, I think, is something amazing, and to cut the middlemen, to cut the people who really control everything, for me, is absolutely amazing. No? But of course, we are seeing a lot of problems and a lot of excess of this, no? They are good things and they are bad things. Decentralization is amazing, but brings a lot of problems, no? That we need to think about how to solve them. I can talk not only from the point of view of the collector, but also, of course, from the point of view of the NFT creator, no? And I realize that, as most of you or all of you must know, they are almost right now, today, almost 30 million of NFT around, no? 30 million. So every day, because I am very interested, every day I check many different, the main marketplaces, no? And platforms, and I see what the people is producing day by day. And I see every day, I find a lot of amazing artwork, no? Amazing. And I believe that, you know, every single artwork has so much effort and so much money, so much time behind, no? And you can see thousands every single day. Amazing things that they are like forgotten somehow by the amazing things that they will be on next day, and later on next day, and later on next day, and so on, no? So for the artist, I believe that it is, for somebody who put all the effort and all the expectations in producing NFTs, can be sometimes a bit frustrating to see how the market operates with a kind of indifference. No? The reality is almost impossible to really be showcased or to be highlighted or to be discovered. No? So any artist has three ways to promote their own work. No? One way is the thing that we are almost all of us, we are doing, that is to upload and to post our NFTs, drop our NFTs anywhere in social media space, no? This is, I think this is good, this is necessary, because you need to really show the people what you are doing, no? But it's totally, if you can see, you see, you know, but it's totally random, it's totally chaotic, and it's extremely difficult to really find in this media your collector, no? Sometimes, yes, happens, no? But it's that doesn't happen very, very, very usually. So this is one, and this is the most frequent, and this is one that I believe that we all should keep doing, no? The second one is a very good job that the platforms and marketplaces are doing, that is promoting, highlighting, showcasing different creators with different styles, but the problem is these promotions, these showcases, these highlights on the websites are very short, and after this these creators showcased are replaced by another one, and the queue and the line is very long. No, people, a lot of people waiting, a lot of people expecting to be there. But I believe this is another way, no, to be promoted and so to be showcased. We created another way that I believe that people should consider. People is considering already, you know, that is to create some kind of awards. Something. This is a system that works very well for another creative disciplines. I can put the evidence over the table that it worked very well for many young professionals, no? But I gave a lot of awards to people just starting, and after this, people getting a lot of clients, no? Because of course an award gives you much more visibility and much more credibility. So something that works so well for young architects or for young graphic designers or for young artists or for young product designers, it should work for young NFT creators, no? But we don't stop here making the just giving an NFT award, no? This is the first step. It's very important for us to create a way to connect much more directly, much more straightforward, no? We organize these creative awards in 15 different categories, no? As creators that they are interested in many different things and many different subjects and categories, they are also collectors that they are interested in some very, very specific categories, no? Later I would like to talk a little bit more in another video about how many types of collectors they are, because there are many types of collectors. There's no one collector, as there is no one artist, no? But I believe that the Creative Awards is a very good way to really connect directly the artist with the collector, no? I believe this is very important. As they are artists that they are very, very interested in creating a very, very specific kind of work, they are collectors, they are looking for this, no? And for the collectors, it's extremely hideous and tiring to be going platform by platform or marketplace by marketplace looking for the things they like, no? So I believe it's very tiring and also sometimes work, but works in a very, very random way, no? Works well, I believe, especially for random collectors, no? Most of the collectors they are not looking for, no? Most of the collectors they find, no? They reach, no? They are, collectors are prepared to reach things, no? But I believe that they are, for one side, the random collectors, no? The people interested in a very, very wide subject, and they see something and they buy. But they are also another collectors, and I deal with them, no? That they are very, very, very interested in only one thing, no? In one very specific subject, no? In one very specific category, and in something very specific inside this category, no? So for them, it's really, really, really tiring to find something. This happens in the art, physical art world, and this is happening in NFT. No? Apart from trying to really create the most straightforward connection between the creator and the appropriate collector, our idea is to buy the biggest amount of awarded NFTs that we can with the fees we get, no, from the submissions. This is our idea, to create a complete ecosystem and to not stop giving an award. No? I believe that to give an award, it's very good for the people to get it, because of course put the artist in a totally different level, but is insufficient. No, I believe that it's not enough doing this. No, we need to somehow, the award should be to buy this NFT. No, and this is why we plan to build an awarded NFT museum, to put all the NFTs that we can afford to buy from the fees of the people that is submitting the NFT. So this is the idea how everything should work as a complete ecosystem. This is our main goal, not only to give the awards, but also create a place, to create a space, showcase all together the awarded NFTs in all the different categories. No? Collectors, sometimes they are not only looking for a specific work. Yes, they are, but also they like to follow quite close the career of the artist who created this NFT that they like. No? I believe that this is also interesting to know. The way we connect is not only connecting one specific only NFT, but also to connect the artist who is behind this NFT. So that's why I believe that it's very important to support, it's very important to send your NFTs to the Creative Awards, because it's not only to get an award that is important. It's something that is good for the community. It's not good only for a group of people, no? Everybody, I think, gets benefits of this, no? So I believe that this is very important to think about and to consider this. And luckily, many people is already acting and already submitting, no? So thank you very much, and let's talk a little bit more about NFTs in the next video. Thank you very much, and see you soon.